Today we are going to talk about masturbation. Masturbation is a concern to many men. Is it harmful? Does it cause erectile dysfunction? Does it cause balding? Will it drain the body from testosterone and energy? If you're concerned too, you might want to watch this video. My name is Dr. Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist and specialist in sexual health. In this video, I will tell you the truth about masturbation. There is so much false and misleading information on social media that you may need some guidance from an expert. However, I'm afraid I'm also going to unlock a new fear. Because of social media, it looks like Dhat Syndrome is spreading rapidly around the globe. Dhat what? Stay tuned to find out if you're in danger. But first things first, here comes a very important message. Let me be clear. Masturbation is not harmful. It doesn't lower testosterone. It doesn't cause baldness. It won't ruin your physical performance. And no, it won't drain your energy or block your path to success. These are myths, not medical facts. I didn't name all the things I've heard and read. So once again, masturbation is not harmful. If you are struggling with life, like any human being, don't blame it on masturbation. Well, maybe not Franz Beckenbauer. He was like King Midas. Everything he touched turned to gold, but then even he had a hard time towards the end of his life. Okay, now, if you are still not convinced that it is completely harmless to touch yourself, I want you to touch the subscribe and like buttons. This is totally risk-free and costs nothing. But it signals that you like my content and it rewards me for my work because I put many hours into each video I upload. Thank you. Besides, it would be a sin not to. I mean, if you believe in the concept of sin, then masturbation would be a sin as well from a religious standpoint. But I'm not a priest. And the name of my channel is not Eurochurch. I stand for enlightenment and scientific truth. However, masturbation may become a problem under certain circumstances if it interferes with your work or social life. What I mean by that is that you can't work because you have to watch porn and masturbate. If it causes you to risk your job or if you stop meeting friends because of it, then you have a problem, or if masturbation involves unhealthy practices. I can't go into detail because of community guidelines, but as a rule, whenever you need supplies from the hardware store for it, penile health could be in danger. Now, let's talk about Dhat syndrome. This is a condition where men become intensely anxious about losing semen, believing it drains their energy, causes weakness, or leads to serious health issues. Originally described in South Asia, Dhat syndrome has been recognized as a culture-bound anxiety disorder. It stems from the belief, deeply rooted in Ayurvedic traditions, that semen is a vital life force and losing it through masturbation, nocturnal emissions, or sex leads to physical and mental decline. But here's where it gets interesting. In recent years, social media and online movements like NoFap have helped spread these anxieties worldwide, leading more men, especially those with conservative attitudes about sex, to fear semen loss. While Dhat syndrome was once thought to be limited to specific cultures, it's now appearing in Western countries, driven by misinformation and fear-based narratives. The result? Anxious men convicted that normal bodily functions are ruining their health. But is there any real scientific basis for these fears? Let's break it down. Is there any scientific basis for the fear of semen loss? The answer is no. There's absolutely no evidence that ejaculation weakens the body, drains vital energy, or causes long-term health problems. Semen is primarily composed of water, proteins, and small amounts of minerals like zinc and magnesium. Losing it does not deplete your body in any meaningful way. Your body naturally regenerates semen, just as it regenerates blood cells. What about testosterone? Studies have shown that ejaculation has little to no effect on long-term testosterone levels. While short-term abstinence might cause a slight temporary spike, it's not enough to make a real difference in strength, masculinity, or performance. In fact, prolonged abstinence can lead to increased stress and irritability rather than any real superpower. The idea that semen retention enhances athletic performance comes from old bodybuilding forums, but there is no scientific evidence to support it. More importantly, the real problem with Dhat syndrome is not the loss of semen, it's the fear and anxiety surrounding it. Men who believe ejaculation is harmful can develop real symptoms like fatigue, depression, and weakness, not because of semen loss, but because of their obsessive worry over it. This is known as somatization, where psychological stress manifests as physical symptoms. The rise of nofap and semen retention movements has contributed to spreading these fears globally, reinforcing misinformation that ejaculation somehow weakens men. In reality, science does not support these claims. If you are feeling tired, unmotivated, or depressed, don't blame semen loss. Look at your sleep, diet, stress levels, and mental health. Ejaculation is a normal and healthy function, and the real danger lies in misinformation and anxiety-driven beliefs, not in semen loss itself. If you're struggling with these fears, talk to a doctor or a specialist who can help you separate fact from fiction. Masturbation is normal human behavior. If you are curious about the science behind it, this video will break it down for you. If you want to know why the inventor of breakfast cereal sends you right to hell, this video will enlighten you. Thanks for watching.
Bye-bye.